Ladies, gentlemen, welcome to Against the Storm. I know you're expecting another Witch Hunters campaign video today, but it's New Year's Day, so Happy New Year. And I thought I would do something a little bit different. So, this is a city builder, but it has vague roguelike elements to it. So it's not a city builder in the sense of you'll be going on forever until you get bored. It's a case of little bite-sized villages that you construct to try and gather resources for the inevitable apocalypse that will reset the world, and then you start all over again. So, yes, let's have a look, shall we? So, because it's okay, well, let's start with, this is the smoldering city. It is built into a volcano, and this is the only safe place from the blight storm, aka the apocalypse, which I mentioned about maybe a minute ago. The idea is that every time the blight storm comes around, the world, except for the smoldering city itself, is wiped completely clean. And then the, I believe the viziers or something like that, as they are called, I can't actually remember what they're called. Oh, viceroys, there we go. Yes, they are then sent out into the world to gather as many resources as possible before the next one. So, I have already finished two here. I don't know why I went for that one. I probably should have gone for like somewhere like here or something. Because you can see here that we gather all food or all resources within a certain radius. So it is within, well, one tile of the place we build. And yeah, so you kind of want to, how do I put it? You want to use your time wisely, because there is only a certain amount of time until the next blight storm, so you want to be very careful with where you go. Now, you can only go within a certain limit of previous towns, so you can't just go like straight out here, for example. But yeah, for my first few villages, because I am relatively new to city builders, the only one I've played before is SimCity. I can't remember which version of SimCity, but yes, that's the only one I've really played. So yeah, I'm just sort of taking my time here. So I think maybe here will be a good place for us to build a new settlement, because that then will allow us to go over here and grab that question mark, potentially. Also, Royal Woodland's pretty good for, well, wood. And I get 14 resources. Yeah, food stockpiles. Yes, I get 14 of that. So, yeah, let's go here. Alright. And for this, we can now choose our caravan type. So, there are many different races. Well, I say there are many different races. Currently, I know of four. So, you have humans, beavers, lizards, and I unlocked harpies last time, though I don't appear to have actually got any here. So, you can choose whether you want the eight humans and all these resources that they bring with them. Or, you can go for the boar. Mixed race beavers lizards contingent, with some vegetables, some meat, eggs, parts, wildfire essences for our hearths, barrels, wood, coal. Now, humans are good jack of all trades, but beavers are really good at the in the beginning, because they are good at woodcutting, appropriately enough. Though I have had a beaver and a lizard colony. The previous two I did were beaver and lizard focused. So I guess I've not done a human focused colony yet. Unknown seasonal conditions. Alright. And yes, I am going to be playing on the easy difficulty, the settler difficulty. Purely because, again, I'm new and... Oh, I didn't actually realise you can actually put in specific names. I will just let it randomly generate one. Yeah, I'm new, and obviously explaining all of this is going to take some time, so I'd rather a nice, relaxing, well, about as relaxing as this game can be. Damn birds. Alright. Gift of the Woodlands. The Royal Woodlands are very lush and rich in timber. Trees give more wood. And settlers' luck. Villagers have 35% chance of not consuming food during a break. Very useful. Mysteries. We have Berry New Year. Active during the drizzle season. And you get +3 to berries production. So, during drizzle season, harvest berries. Good to know. Cricket meeting grounds. Clearings are abuzz with the sound of crickets. As opposed to birds. Getting 30 insects for each discovered glade. Well, there does seem to be a few glades. The glades are these sort of foggy areas over here. But there is also looming darkness, which reduces our resolve during storm. And eerie song. Active from hostility 5. Hopefully we won't get up to hostility 5. Villagers with this effect have a 5% chance of perishing every 15 seconds. Oh god. Yeah, let's hope we don't get up to hostility 5. Nope. Right. Hang on a minute. Where's all the people? Oh, they're all, I think, garrisoned in the hearth. Okay. Yeah, no, there they are. I forget they wear these sort of cloaks. It's probably the right word. So, this is the hearth. It's the heart of our village. You can only build houses in the area surrounding a hearth. You can build more, but yeah, the resources to build them are in very short supply. So you want to be a little bit careful of that. Also, you have to keep it fueled, much like in Frostpunk, I believe it's called. Which I have also played. I forgot I have played that. Yeah, but unlike in this, you're not going to be getting freezing conditions every like 2 minutes and then running out of coal and then dying, which was my sort of was pretty much my thing with that game. That's all that happened to me. I'm terrible at it. And we also have the main warehouse, where everything is stored. As your city expands, or your village expands, obviously you can build more warehouses, so people have less far to travel for depositing stuff. Now, to start with, let's choose some new buildings. So what do we want? Skewers, biscuits, pigment. A cookhouse could be quite good. A brickyard. Well, we will need a brickyard if we want to make a cookhouse, because we do not, I believe, have that many bricks. Building materials. Yeah, we have no brick. Okay. Ore smelter for copper bars, copper crystallized geo biscuits. Let's get a brickyard, we can get the cookhouse later. Weaver. Another one that's difficult to go between. Well, we're going to need the weaver first before we get the clothier, so. And there we got the clothier. But we've also got a lumber mill. Of course. Clothier is good for the happiness of our villagers, because you can make coats. Lumber mill is good for the... that requires brick, and I don't have it again. I can still make planks without a lumber mill, so I guess we go with clothier. Alright. So first things first, let's get some wood production going. And two down here, maybe? And let's get some housing. Alright, let's put out some roads and then we'll get some housing. And let's do the usual, put road around that. Make that the sort of city centre. Two. One. Two. That should be enough. Each shelter gives you three places, so yeah, I've got eight. So that is good. Sacrificing. During especially hard times, you can sacrifice additional goods to gain temporary positive effects. I see. Consumes resources at a very high rate. Forty wood per minute grants hostility reduced by 50, 80. That increases work speed. That increases production speed. Huh, okay. Alright. We're also very limited on fuel at the moment. So, want to be a little bit careful of that. We've got eggs there. We have nothing we can get with the foresters' camp. Foragers, sorry. Herbalists, trappers. Let's get a trappers' camp. And let's get a stone cutters camp. Right. Let's assign some woodcutters. That leaves one builder. Alright. We want two builders, probably. Get these houses up. Shelter, we want to assign priority one. They've decided to split the they've split the wood between the various buildings, I think. How much wood do I actually have? 20 left. Yeah, I've got very little fuel. Alright. So, much like in other city builders, you can assign specific things you want harvested in terms of trees. So let's do that. So we want to go and grab those glades. We have a cornerstone. Right, these are permanent perks that you can get every so often. So we can get either a fiber delivery line to get plant fiber coming in, or local taxes to give us amber for every 100 ale produced. Amber is the currency, by the way. Personally, I'd say the plant fiber here is better because I'm useless at getting to the point of producing ale. And we also have some orders from the Queen of the Smoldering City. So we can select booming economy or camps. Well, create a clay bundle of reeds, or three parts, or two villages, some oil vessels, and some amber. Can I actually get a harvester's camp? It might actually be worth going for the value of goods sold. Just getting a trading post out. Yeah, I can get a harvester's camp. I don't need it, but I can get it. So that's an easy one to complete. And parts are hard to come by, so I'll grab that one. Exploration. Cut through the forest to discover three glades. Or help from the queen. Have six humans for 30 seconds. Ooh, now that's actually quite... You have a small number of farm fields nearby to produce vegetables and grain. Fungal growth. Oh, we're getting some infestors here, are we? Plus one to mushroom production. Well, we have no mushrooms at the moment, so that's not particularly useful. At least I didn't see any. Let's go for exploration, because scouts pack, workers assigned to glade events can carry 5 more items. Pretty useful when you start getting more and more glade events. Problem solver. Complete any 2 glade events. Tools, 3 newcomers and planks, or amber trade, value of goods sold 8, and then 4 extra amber on top of that, gives us some simple tools, a wildfire essence to construct another half and 2 newcomers. I'd probably say problem solver. Is there actually any, no, there is no mushrooms around here. Okay, let's take a look at our local area. So, we have peaceful. Okay, so we have a fair few peaceful glaives around, but we also have a few danger ones, which are indicated by these skulls. They can be problematic if you are unprepared for them. So the idea is that you assign a couple of people to them, and you clear them for better rewards. But there is a obviously detriment to doing so. I don't think anyone specifically dies. I mean, you can have people die from it's not Harvester's Camp, is it? It is Forager's Camp, yes. Yes. The glade events sometimes can kill off villagers if left alone for too long. Forbidden Glade. The Crown sends a warning about this glade. It's very dangerous and requires a lot of resources to explore, but will contain great amounts of treasure. You know what? Maybe I'll leave that alone. Also, I should really get some paths going over here, so that I can move a bit faster. Villagers moving on paths move 5% faster, which is quite useful. Getting a lot of roots. We want that, so I can put another house there if need be. We could actually use our stone, to be honest. Grants a 15% speed increase to villagers. But yeah, for every one of those I put down, yeah, it costs one stone, so we want to be a little bit careful of that. That is a stone cutter's camp, is it not? It is. And here comes the looming darkness. Thanks to storm. Yay. Is it worth unassigning my woodcutters so that the hostility of the forest here does not keep ticking up? How much wood have I got? 108. Alright. Let's unassign you all for a minute. And I guess put you to work on other things while we weather the storm. Let's get you on vegetables. Ah, now this is what humans are proficient in. So you can mouse over this and you can see that humans are good at farming and brewing. So any camps that they're assigned to that have this specialization bonus here, the farming one, humans are going to, there we go, I have a chance of doubling their yield, which is pretty useful. Speed up the game a bit. Stick up the times two. Is there any plantation space at all? No, it doesn't appear to be. Right. So, we are going to want some planks, some fabric, and some clay. Okay. So now we can go back over to wood. Should there actually be any... where did I assign those to? It's clay. Right, let's get one off there. And you go back to that wood trap, that woodcutter's camp. We want to get through to that glade. Ooh, also, newcomers. So, every so often, I think it's like yearly or something, you get newcomers. Pervan Runebeak. Yes, this is definitely one of those sort of fantasy style things. So we can get a human, a harpy, and a lizard, or two lizards and a harpy. Well, I don't know about you, but I think I've got enough humans. The berries that this group here come with is pretty nice. But these come with insects and a bit of coal, so I'm all for keeping the fire going. So say hello to the lizards, the lizard people, and the harpy, which I can't click on because she's currently embedded into the fire. No, it won't let me select her. All right, I've never had a harpy before. I only unlocked them after the last one. So I got no homeless, that's fine. Cleanliness. Bathhouse, holy market, market. Harpies have an innate need to take care of themselves. Okay, so I think harpies are going to be another one of those that are very difficult to take care of. Okay, so every single faction, or every single race, has a specific series of needs that they need to fulfill. And once they reach a certain threshold here, indicated by that little blue line up the top left corner there, yeah, they'll start giving you free reputation points over time, which is quite useful. Right, so let's kick you two out and replace you with lizards, because they are good at that. You go there. Yeah, you can see what they actually need from this little thing you can extend here. So yeah, you can get various different housing types, you can get jerky, which is what I kind of want to move towards, but I don't know. Actually, I think humans and beavers are the only ones with clothing needs, so clothing's not actually that important at the moment. Ah, they want biscuits. These guys want pickled goods. Though it seems like everyone is a fan of brawling, except for humans. Humans want religion, lizards want religion. Yeah, it's a matter of trying to balance everything out. So we want also someone to do... They excel at alchemy and love to work with cloth. Well, you'll kind of get your wish, but you're going to have to actually make some of the fabric before you can start working with the cloth at the weaver. Oh, and a cornerstone as well, I forgot about that. Rich glades, plus 5 for small deposits, plus 20 for large deposits. Pretty good. Relatives, family gratitude, relatives of your villagers send gifts for treating their family members well. Get 40 water skins for every full reputation point obtained through higher resolve. Yeah, I'm too bad at this game to ever get that, so let's go for rich glaives. Glaives? Glades. And we got a glade with sea marrow deposits, good for the hearth, and bleeding tooth mushrooms. And a field, a big field as well. Well, we're going to instantly want a plantation over there. And we are going to want to build farm fields. Some of that is covered by trees. It's a little bit annoying. Let's move that over here so it's a little bit close to the tree line. You will move over. Those two dangerous, aren't they? Yeah, those two dangerous ones. We have no people again. What's this? Reinforced needles. 1 fabric production. Fulfill villagers' need for clothing 30 times. Well, we only have one group that actually requires clothing. But then I also can't make luxury goods, to my knowledge. We should cut through to this relatively shortly. We've had no glade events so far. But hopefully we can get some soon. There are safe glade events as well, but... right, you're good at farming, so you can go over there. I don't think we need any of this for the time being. So they are delivering. then we will unassign them. Alright. You head over there. Yeah, when you're starting out, you do have to kind of sort of move between all the different things, but eventually you'll get enough villagers that you'll be fine. So, plant fibre, I wouldn't plant those, to be honest. I'd focus on food at the minute. Although, saying that, we are actually going down plant fibre wise, so, okay, get some. And now the storms have come again. I've got 3 woodcutters. Well, that's got no one in it, so I can move that out of the way. And move the path up. Okay. That's very flashy. Should be alright. Problem is, I'm not epileptic, so I don't actually know what can and can't trigger a seizure. I could just actually turn off the flashing. There we go. That's probably better for the video. 3 packs provisions done. Another pack and we should be fine. Drizzle year 3. Excellent. Lost in the wilds, gain 1 new villager every time you discover a glade. Well-rested workers, just the right amount. Villagers with the leisure need fulfilled have a 20% chance of doubling their yields. I'm going full on glades at the moment, so let's do the villager one. Because I find myself in dire need of them. Trader, please give me something useful. No copper bars. But it is Sahilda, so yeah, you have different types of traders. So you have a human, a beaver, presumably a lizard, and they all do different things. We're not doing too well on this village so far. Oh god, this is nearly an hour. Well, this is going to get cut down. Ooh, I can deliver this finally. Happy humans. Or sacrificing. Human friendship. 2 additional humans will come with each group of newcomers. Ooh. A basket of pies. And an ancient sewing technique. Okay. Let's do happy humans. We only need to get them up 2 more resolve, so it's fine. Zorg is coming to the settlement. Cooked raw food, pottery tools along with perks, and blueprints tied to agriculture. He's willing to buy packs of goods, raw food, building materials, and some crafting materials. Okay. Speaking of packs, yeah, the lizard's not doing anything at the moment, so. Got a human there. Gather some more roots and vegetables. Bump that with priority list. And it's rain season again. Joy. We're running out of plant fibres. That's kind of annoying. We are not actually... Yeah, we're only harvesting it from one farm. We have a lot of food at the moment. It's worth making just plant fibers. We're going to want another plantation. Then farm field. Nearly got need for clothing fulfilled. That's something. You are going to rest, that's fine. You don't need anything at the moment. If you can build that, and then we'll put you... Do we put you on the farm, or do we put you... Let's make that a plant fight ward. Might put them on the farm, actually. God, a lot of unmanned things. Stonecutters has no deposits. That's fine. We will... set you to farming for a minute. Get some plant fibers in. Exploration training. For every 5 villagers with a need for brawling fulfilled, the chance of bringing back twice as many goods from the events increases by 20%. Protected trade. As the forest recedes, the heavily guarded trade caravans pour into the settlement. Hostility is reduced by 15 points every time you sell goods worth 25 amber. Exploration training. We get brawling stuff later, so... might be worth actually going to have a look into one of these dangerous glades soon. So it looks like that's the only way that we're going to manage to do glade events. One copper bar, that's going to get us absolutely nothing. I want 2 humans though for the farm, so... Alright, you two, back to whatever you were doing. Harpy, you can go to the harvester's camp. What are we here? Berries. Ooh, more farmland. A lot of farmland here. Queen's starting to get a little impatient, but still nothing major. Need for clothing is fulfilled, so that's something. Yes, deliver that. Trapper's camp, advanced camp, advanced camp, advanced camp. Do we have any large deposits? Not appear so, though glades normally have large camps. Let's get the trapper's one. and mark these trees. Do we have any more? Yes, so we've got four people that aren't doing anything. I really need some decorations. Let's put some benches down here. There we go. Then that will, hopefully, when they're built, allow us to, you know, upgrade this hearth, or hearth even. You know, it doesn't overwrite the farmland, so I might just stick it here so they're not having to go all the way around for it. Mark those. Hubs. Yeah. We can always set up ancient hearths over, or hearths over in other places, but at the moment, we're not really out of space. I think it might actually be wise to dig this out as well. Well, not dig, but chop it out. Why are you... Oh, there's a glade event behind, isn't there? I don't have the simple tools. It's 3 minutes away. Alright. Right. Sorry, just pause the video to make sure I still had space on my hard drive. This seems to be going on for longer than I thought. Okay, that's a lot of... I think maybe for future harvesting we'll make this the berry one and then this can be the flax. Or the plant fibre, sorry. They don't seem to be distributing it evenly. So, okay, so goods basically just teleport between warehouses. That's good to know. Human resolve is done. Perfect. And that unlocks a new thing. Flower. There we go. That makes training gear for the luxury goods, but I want the flour for the biscuits, don't I? That makes simple tools, but it's not going to be worth it because I don't have copper. So, yeah, provisioner. That road is in my way. Path, sorry. Provisioner. There we go. It's very misty. I think we're all doing okay for the moment. When's my next quest? 30 seconds. And I've actually nearly got the lizards to the reputation threshold. Oh, there we go. So yes, now you see they're blue and reputation's going to start going up slowly over time. Ah, it's because we've got pie. They like pie, apparently. How many do I have? Well, first off, I need grain. Hallowed small farm, small farm. Bugger. Wait a minute. I never picked orders from... Oops. Value of goods sold, or ancient tablets and glades. go for the glades. Need for clothing for fields. Or more glades. Ancient tablets. Ton of food. Or a pack of building materials. What do building materials need? Planks. How many? Do I already have some building materials? 2. So I am already working on that. I need 12. Villagers move 10% quicker. That's actually pretty good. So we'll get that. Builder's tools. No, I'm not giving you my simple tools. Although that is pretty good for those upgrades. But am I ever going to be able to fulfill that request? Because there is no way I can get copper here. Not at the moment. How many tools, or how much copper does it take to 3? Oh, I can use crystallized dew. Hang on. Oh, I forgot about that. So, if I make brickyard, stone plus herbs plus spark dew. Well, some sort of source, some sort of food anyway. I can make tools. Aha! Right. In that case, we're going for that. Still not completed any glade events because of the lack of tools. Alright. Right. We found a problem. We need some resin. Okay. Termite infestation. Harvesting and planting are 50% slower during the getting rid of this thing. And stone tooth swarm. -5 to global resolve while that's being worked on. Meanwhile, agitated swarm. If this is not cleared in 10 minutes, destroys all stored building materials. You know, I think I'll take the temporary loss in global resolve and harvesting and planting speed to not lose every single building material that I own. There is also some simple tools there. Excellent. Okay, let's sell him some coats. We've got plenty of those. Sell him 50 of them. And let's sell all my packs of provisions. All my packs of crops. So that's 15. And with that, I can buy 5 simple tools. No, 6 simple tools. That's not a lot. General donation, bigger barrels, orderly storage. Kind of in a bit of a bind here, to be honest. I throw in 3 amber. Can I get any more? Oh, I can get 8 if I throw in something else. Okay. There we go. Throw in a brick and suddenly that's fine. I can get 8. There we go. Need for clothing is fulfilled. I need that for another 30 seconds and that's fine. In the meantime, okay, we have one homeless person, so we want to get a shelter up. If only it were that easy in real life. What's this? A medium abandoned cache needs 8 simple tools. That's kind of annoying. I've just used a load. Advanced fuel. All fuel recipes are faster. Reinforced axes. Wood cutting is a lot easier. Woodcutters camp production is 40% quicker. Well, obviously we're going for the woodcutters. Yeah, this would have been the better one to go for instead of this. I take it I don't actually have. Yeah, I've only got 4 left. So if you activate that, newcomers awaiting. Good. I'm tempted to go with a lot of humans here. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the humans one. And we have a ton of homeless people again. We're kind of running out of space. Okay, I wonder if it's worth just tearing down the makeshift post because we're not using it. Provisioner. We have some grain now, so we want to get someone to do that. We don't want any packs provisions. We don't want barrels. We want nothing but flour from them. Small foresters camp. Foragers camp, sorry. So, right, they're harvesting that root deposit, but that's gonna go in like any second now. Okay. Build a house there. That one tree there that I want removed, but I cannot remove it. I think I can't just delete it. No. That'd be too easy. Yeah, maybe it is time for another hearth then. I can't remember what it's under. There it is. I can afford it. Yeah. 5 insects per minute. There we go, that's quite nice. And we can move this as well, so that's quite useful. We are in drizzle, so let's reassign our lump cutters. Oh, hostility of the forest just went up. That's kind of bad. But not much we can do on that one. I'm out of coal. I have a ton of sea marrow. Simple tools can apparently be burned. I don't really think that's a good idea. Oh, that's just fire and exploration. Okay. Wood, yeah, going down heavily because of the fact we had to take the woodcutters off. Alright, let's assign some more woodcutters. Have you sort of woodcutting around here? That would be quite good. So we want a firekeeper. What do the harpy firekeepers do? Campment. Does not specify. It's possible that's just because it's not lit yet. Hmm. Not sure. Alright, let's build a shelter here. Let's move the termite nest. Build another shelter here. We're getting quite far away from our workshop again. Not our workshop. Where else? We are out of wood. Yeah, we definitely need to up our wood game. Head towards that glade. There's a slight downpour. We're not out of clothing. But yeah, everyone seems to be getting really... okay, the pies have worn off. Do I have the bakery? Yes. Right. If you would not mind cooking. What is that? Warmth. Bring. Prefer to work in warm environments. Well, there you go then. It's your lucky day. And you, sir, can get reassigned. Or ma'am, I don't know. Yep, you can go in there. Ah, sea marrow. Good. Might need more of that soon, because our current supply is going down. I don't want to end up having to burn anything else. Alright. I've got a cornerstone. Stormwalk attacks. You'll gain 15 amber every time a new group of villagers arrive, but you'll lose all stored amber upon choosing this cornerstone. Strange roots spread across the land. Wood production increased by 1, but harvesting and planting are 25% slower. That's kind of annoying. Okay, how much... how much amber do I have? Literally none. Might as well then. And I've unlocked the final two orders. Pack of trade goods and building materials. Or need for jerky, need for skewers, and need for pickled goods. Well, I am working towards the skewers and jerky. Pottery for a minute. Actually, no, you're building some already, so I suppose we might as well. Let's... nope, not limit. We want to prioritise. That's the one. Prioritise those above pottery, please. So, can we make what it's asking for? I do not believe so. We've only got two choices left, so if we don't get something that can, we are in trouble. We can't, so... actually, can we do trade goods and building materials? Yes. Yes, we can. Okay, so we will do that then. It's going to be costly, but what can you do? Playing with fire. Dangerous glaives. Glaives? I keep saying glaives. It's not glaives, it's glades. Can I make any glade events? I can complete two dangerous glaives. Too dangerous or forbidden. Create copper ore, new villages, and advanced smelting. Well, I don't have a smelter, so that's utterly useless. Suppose we just go with the leather and coats then. Assume I can get some leather somewhere. Obtained by ranch. Is that literally it? In that case, I definitely can't do it. If I get rid of those. Might be able to get some from... Yeah, I might be able to get some from trading, so that's not too bad. I have enough clothing, I think. It might be time to maybe get them to cease. Trade has arrived. And of course, she has no leather, but she does have a lot of flour. And some grain. I have no amber at the moment. Shame I can't sell the coats. Though, sturdy boots. Can I somehow wrangle my way into getting those? It does not look so. No. Well, I can, but it's going to cost me, like, way too much. Alright. Screw that, then. Stonecutter's camera has no deposits nearby. Cool. Move you over here, then. Let's also set up the farm over here. Plantation. I'll have to move that lumber camp. Starting towards that dangerous one. Over this plantation. I swear I had a thing that made those sort of. What was it? Was it the brickyard, wasn't it? Yeah. So where'd I put the brickyard? Am I going mad? It's right here. Alright. Prioritize that. That should be a priority 3. No arrivals. 4 humans, 3 harpies, or 2 lizards, 3 humans, 2 harpies. Do I want to give up a human and a harpy for 2 lizards? I would probably say yes. Yes, I do. And we got one unfortunate individual who has no home currently. It's fine by me. We'll build a shelter there. Move that out the way. Seem to be doing alright at the minute. We are losing fuel still. I get the feeling we're going to need another woodcutter's camp. Though that is really going to piss off the forest. We've actually got a lot of places. Herbert's camp would be quite useful. So let's get some more stuff going for that. We are actually out of flour. Ah, mushrooms. It can be used to make flour. I'm not sure if that's entirely accurate, but you know what? We'll go for it. Specialization bonus is alchemy. Alright, oh, in that case, we'll get two harpies to do it. We are actually out of stone cutting. Ooh, a small encampment. New people or send to Citadel? I'm actually tempted to send to Citadel, because I am going to need to make some purchases. Let's use the insects, because we got like 200,000 of them. This... simple tools... Stop clicking on that thing! Scouts are idle in small encampment. Send to Citadel. We shall send them to their new home. And I've also found no goddamn ancient tablets. Which is kind of annoying. I've got so little wood. So, 6 woodcutters. So, it's what? It's about 6 per woodcutter. Also, that quest's complete now. That rainproof coats. So we got 5 new people. We're now going to find homes for. See, at this point, it's just a case of now we have too many people. But hey-o, could be worse. Let's build a path over here. Go. All is going well. Actually, I wonder if it's... Ah, so that's an ancient hearth. This is a small hearth. Right, so what is this? A lumber mill. Okay. It's not bad. Forgotten Temple of the Sun. Oh dear. The temple demands offerings. Destroy all trade goods in the warehouse. Well, you can fuck right off. Thankfully, I can beat this. And it's not going to cause any negative effects. Get the lizards to do it, because I seem to be good at it. Quite frankly. Yes, cornerstone. Golden marrow. Some fossils contain valuable surprises. Gain 2 amber for every 20 sea marrow produced. And all fuel recipes are 33% faster. Do I actually have any recipes? I don't think I do. So, golden marrow. Right. So, I need to start making packs of building materials. I need to find some ancient tablets, which I've still not done. Which means there's going to be some around somewhere. Probably in Dangerous Glades. I don't think I could have buggered this particular place up more if I tried. Grab that. How many of these do I have? I have 6. Okay. You two go on that. Oh, we're still out of houses. Okay. Oh, I'm really not liking my chances with that. Food stockpiles and ponds of fabric. we'll go for it. What's this? Ah, ancient tablets. Okay, well, I need to save up 12 simple tools then. Move that over there. Newcomers are waiting. Alright. That's fine. We'll grab coal. Okay, I don't care who comes with that. I need the coal. I really do. And we're really upsetting the forest by doing this. But there's not much we can do, sadly. That is now... That Temple of the Sun's now not a threat. Oh, does that have a... No. Oh, I thought it had a shark sticking out of it for a minute. Like, as in, it just sort of had some sort of Sharknado-style thing where it's gone directly into a building. Alright. Let's assign 3 people, rebuild, investigate. We're going to need even more houses now because we've just got some more people. So let's put in some here. I have a lot of people not doing anything, so we are going to have to try and... speaking of not doing anything, you're idling. So the forest is nearly level 2. Oh, they are at 1. Okay. Whatever happened to those biscuits? I was never making them because I didn't select the right resources, of course. Go me. Right. I should probably start make a second bakery just to get that rolling. And it's increasing again. Good. Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Oh, I thought I had a small trapper's camp. Oh well, you get on to that then. Tintsiri. Ancient Shrine. This is the one that, this is the one that kills villagers, so we really kind of want to get that done now. Disturbing the ruins of great civilization can have grave consequences. Kills 5 random villagers. Yes. So definitely get that sorted. Rebuild the Tintsiri. I'm never going to say no to a free building. Medium abandoned cash with copper bars, ale, and coats. What do I need copper bars for? Of the tools, wasn't it? Yeah, well, I've sorted that problem now, so... I have that, so... Lizards, take care of that. A large dewberry bush. Some large mushrooms there. Scout to idol in ancient shrine. Why? Because I did not select a thing, did I? Hostility of the forest is affecting their happiness. Um Don't worry about ale. You know what I never actually made? I never made the clan hall. Because I don't have room for it, that's right. So I built this in the wrong place. Put it down here instead of up here, where it would cover more. Yeah, I thought maybe about expanding down here, but that's not gonna seem. That doesn't seem to be the way things are gonna go. Alright. Well, that should, in theory, be gone soon, so I can make a place here. You can grab these roots. Trade has arrived, excellent. What do I want? Specialized boots for the woodcutters. I'd say. Special set of alchemical tools. I can technically afford all of this. So what are my actual orders? So two ancient tablets, which I'm going to get in a minute. A pack of building materials. Okay. Ancient tablets have been taken somewhere. Oh. This is resolve is low. Okay. This is a problem. Right. Let's get rid of some of this. Can we reduce it down a level? Yes, we can. Good. Right. Hostility to the forest has gone down one, so we can actually now at least keep our villagers. If their resolve gets too low, then eventually they'll just start saying, screw this, I'm off. I'm very much out of resources on that one. Okay. Season has passed. We completed an order, and we got a new cornerstone. Well-rested workers. Boom. Cookhouse. Skewers, biscuits, pigment. Yes, because that has skewers in it. Yes. Let's build it here. Ooh, there's a yeah. Be able to do that, are we? How far away are we? Still two away. Alright. So that's Storm Madness. Newcomers awaiting. What do they bring with them? Anything good? Leather or pottery roots, amber. Okay, we're doing well on the woodcutting front. Ooh, I've also just noticed that I've completed two objectives. Oh, that'll be the end then. Yes! Oh dear. After 2 hours, that's not bad. I like how at the very beginning I said, this is bite size. And then, yeah, it took me about 2 hours. I am going to try and cut this down, though, so you should see it all in one video. Because a lot of the time, I am just pottering around, basically. 20-minute adventure. Game finished before year 12. I was on year 11, so, yeah, that's... Yeah, no villagers died, no villagers left the town. 60 villagers, at least. We had 50 amber. We completed 3 dangerous events. 7 regulars, 11 orders. The queen had 9 impatience left. We had 12 reputation, and we got a win. So, You can continue, but I think we'll be going back to the world map. You cannot keep anything that you get after that. So, now that we've done that, we can go to the Smoldering City and start upgrading things. Ooh, also I've got some deeds. Win 3 games, good. That's more experience for me. That's more experience for me. As is that. And as is that. So now we've got new citizen upgrade, new citizen upgrades. Sutha the Ancient. Interesting. A new trader. Exploration expedition. Get a constant minus 5 penalty to glow resolve, but plus 15 to glow resolve for 5 minutes every time a new glade is discovered. Interesting. Monastery, press, artisan, frequent caravans. Okay. So I suppose next for me would be to go and play another map, because I've only played the forest once over. See how that goes. But that will not be in this video, because obviously this has been going on for quite some time. I have 27 food stockpile and 1 machinery and nothing else. So I guess the only thing we can upgrade is the obsidian archive. Or a second level of the Pioneer's Gate. But, Queen's Patience. I'm always happy for that. Yeah. And that's it. Now we do it all over again with another area. Maybe I'll go to the marshlands over here. That'd be interesting. Although I do have a thing for the Scarlet Orchard. Yes, this has been Against the Storm. So, thank you very much for watching, everybody. I hope you have enjoyed it. This is a fun little game. I say fun little. It's still in early access at the moment, so keep that in mind if you do decide to purchase. But, yeah. It's entertaining, nonetheless. Nice little city builder. For a few find city builders go on for a bit too long. And until next time, I have been Caldaris. Goodbye.